So we're going to start today actually on our bellies. Face down, stacking your palms so that your forehead is just resting on your palms, elbows out. You can let your legs spread out wide, heels drop out to the side, and just flatten yourself like a pancake. Let the weight of Wednesday wear off. Let's see. And we'll get a little bit of music going. All right. So welcome back, everyone, from Thanksgiving. Deep now into the holiday season. I think we can all feel it. And it's like especially kind of crazy and, you know, kind of welcome to, I think, after last year, to feel like you have a lot of stuff going on. So as you lay here in a prone position, palms stacked, forehead on the back of your hands, and tops of the feet gently relaxing into the floor, heels dropping out. Notice if as you're laying here, you're kind of pushing into the floor. You're resisting the floor. See if you can instead take a deep breath in through your nose. And then exhale, melt your torso down. So just stay there on your belly. I'm going to just come up because it's hard to talk in here when my face is right up against the mat. And so as you lie here on your belly, again, notice if there's any spots that are still a little bit tense, that you feel like you're holding or gripping. See if you can let that go too. So you're just a very loose pool of a human on the ground. Pretty much at ground zero, right? Blank slate. Not even a foundation yet. And so tonight's class is about balance, maybe getting upside down, maybe. We'll be in an inversion regardless of whether or not feet leave the ground. But what's really important is going to be how we slowly build our way up and stack not only our body, but also the muscle memory to get to that place. And so I think that is a good thing to remember, especially as you might be, you know, building towards things that you want to change. I think we always like look to January to make those changes, but you know, potentially it could be something that you want to change right now that you want to commit to or achieve. And it always starts with a very small change. And you create yourself a foundation. I always like the architecture analogies because they resonate with me. And then you have to slowly build on top of that. Jen, I bet that resonates with you too. You too, Elise. And so, you know, without a sturdy foundation, without even starting at the bottom, you don't have anything to build upon. So whether that's making a small shift in a habit, maybe removing a habit, or knowing that you want to build to something and trying to figure out the steps in between. So as you lie here on your belly, you know, maybe think of something that has been resonating with you, potentially like a physical achievement. You want to get handstand one day. Or you just want to get out one morning a week and run. gently bend your knees, starting to get a little bit of integration, and just rock your feet from side to side. So you should start to feel an awakening here in your low back as your pelvis sways a little bit with the rock of your feet. Now, if you haven't already, try sealing your lips so that you're breathing in and out through your nose. Really start to notice your rib cage as it expands and gently presses into the mat. And then as you exhale, then your chest can drop a little bit deeper and melt down. Inhale. Feel your ribs, this structure that's around your lungs. And then exhale. Do that two more times, keeping this gentle rocking motion in your bent knees, swaying from side to side. All right, and then still your legs. Let them drop back down, but we're going to start to add a little bit more integration. Bring your legs together now. Straighten your toes. And then gently press yourself up. We're going to start with a shoulder stretch. You're going to extend your left arm out to the left side, perpendicular to you, palm down. Then gaze away from that arm to the right side. Tent your right fingertips up and set your left ear down on the mat. Keeping your legs super straight and strong, slowly roll yourself onto your left side, keeping your head relaxed down on the mat, opening up your shoulders. A couple things you can do with your legs tonight. You can either keep them stacked, with the top one simply drop back behind the other, or bend that knee and place, so that would be your right foot on the ground. Keep tenting your right fingertips and really press them into the mat so that you can adjust the intensity of this pose. Make sure that your head stays heavy and your neck stays relaxed. Start to move your breath into your chest so that as you inhale, you can really feel that left pectoral. So that's really from the shoulder all the way across to the middle, right to your sternum, start to open. So a lot of work in the shoulders is actually in the chest too. Can't get to one without the other. Take another deep breath in. And then as you exhale, slowly unwind, bringing your legs down, rolling onto your belly, letting your right arm guide you down, and then chin into center. Extend your right palm out. Fingers spread. Make sure that arm is perpendicular to your body. Then gaze to your left, draw your left arm in, tent your fingertips, and rest your head down. All right, from there, keeping your right palm pressing down into the earth, slowly press into your left hand so that you roll onto the right side body. And then take whatever variation with your leg, that top leg you did on the other side. And then as you press into your left palm, left fingertips, to open your shoulder and really feel it in the right pectorals now, the right side of the shoulder, your breath into the upper part of your lungs. You can do very little with the rest of your body. So letting your neck relax, even this bottom leg can stay long, but you know, it's not super important to keep muscular integration here right now. We're using the support still of our mats. Finding a very focused opening in our shoulders, in the front of the shoulders, deltoids. Take another deep breath in through your nose. And then exhale. Slowly unwind. Come back to center. All right, press your hands under your shoulders. Keep your legs together. Gently press yourself up. And then keeping those knees together, you're going to shift your hips back so that your ribs fold over your thighs and your head can come down. Extend your palms down by your side, face up, fingers extending towards your toes. So this is called embryo pose. It's a little bit like child's pose, but it's a lot more tight. Your knees are together. It's a little bit more constricted for breathing. You'll feel your shoulders starting to slump forward and a really big opening in the upper back, the space right behind your heart. All right, we're going to start to add now again a little bit of integration into this pose to deepen the stretch. So with your palms, and this is a little bit of a confusing pose, so it's called rabbit. So if you'd like to, you can watch this first one and then come into it by yourself. I like to think of it as like a seed, but then starting to grow. So you're gonna reach your hands for your heels, fingers to the inside, thumbs to the outside. Lift up your head just a little bit, and then place the top of your head on the mat. Start to lift your hips up so that you roll a little bit onto the top of your head. Keep gripping with your hands to your heels and then pull with your hands. Lift your hips as high as you can. Keep the weight very gentle on the top of your head and maybe reach your forehead towards your kneecaps if you can get a little bit tighter. Then come back down into embryo pose. So if you were watching that first one, now come back down into embryo and we'll all do it together. So again, this is called rabbit pose. So very tight little seed on the ground. Wrap your hands around your heels so the fingertips come to the inside, thumbs to the outside. Scoot your forehead as close as you can to your knees and then gently set the top of your head down. Very tight, very constricted. Then start to lift your hips up. Keep that grip on your heels. Breathe into your upper back. You almost feel like your arms are pulling away from your body. Just a little bit. Keep lifting your heels. Exhale, relax back down into embryo pose. So you might even feel some heat building in your legs in this posture. All right, last time together. Grip your heels if your hands were released. Draw your forehead into your knees. Come to the top of your head. Inhale, lift your hips high. Keep gripping those heels. Stay for another breath cycle. And then exhale, release. Wrap your arms forward. So sweep them around. Rock forward, coming up to all fours. Open your knees wide, keep your big toes together to touch. Then press your hips back, stretch your arms long, bring your forehead down to the mat. Now it's a little bit easier to breathe. Arms are long. Still some heaviness in your legs. Your shoulders feel maybe now a little bit open on the front and on the back side. Then lift your gaze. Slowly come forward. You're going to come all the way back down onto your belly. Bring your legs back in, this time hip width distance apart, and set your forearms down on the ground in front of you. Moving into Sphinx pose, forearms are parallel. Spread your fingers wide and then press your palms down. Start to lift your gaze up so the bottom of your chin is parallel with the ground. You have a nice gentle curvature in your spine. And then press the tops of your feet down, activate your thighs, grip your finger pads down into the mat, and pull your chest through. Sometimes when I'm in rabbit pose, I can actually get a cramp in my abdominals from being so tight and so very compressed in the front body in that pose. So this, if you've experienced something similar, or just like a, almost even like a sense of, fear of tight spaces, claustrophobia, that can be a very claustrophobic pose. So Sphinx is a great counter pose to that. Pull your chest through, keep gripping your hands down, keep your hips heavy so that you're actually finding in a little bit of an elongation and spinal extension. All right, now move your gaze down in between your thumbs. Keep your fingers spread and now tuck your toes. Press down through your forearms. And notice how your upper back starts to lift towards the ceiling. Engage your core. Now you can do this with knees down or lift your knees up, coming into forearm plank. Keep pressing your full palm down, especially that space in between your pointer finger and thumb, where we like to get a little bit light and maybe even a bubble forms under your palm. Squish that bubble down. Keep your gaze down to the mat. Draw your navel up and in. And then notice your breath. Are you breathing through your mouth? Or do you have slow, controlled breaths in and out through your nose? Ujjayi pranayama. Try and keep that ujjayi as you keep a nice long spine. Another breath in. And then as you exhale, slowly lower your hips down to the mat. Press the tops of your feet down. Keep gripping with your palms. Lift your gaze. Pull your chest through. Sphinx pose. Breathe in. And breathe out. See if you can pull your front body nice and long. Stretch those abs. All right. And then again, move your gaze down. Tuck your toes. Activate your legs. Zip your navel up and in. Slowly press yourself back up into a forearm plank. All right. And then from here, you're going to drop both heels to the left side. So your feet are stacked one in front of the other. And then you'll pivot your left palm slightly forward, come into a side plank. So in this side plank, you can keep your right hand down if you want to. You can bring it up to your side. And if you'd like a little bit of a more gentle one, then you can just bring that bottom knee down to the mat. Otherwise, both legs stay stacked. Take a breath in. And out. And breathe in. Exhale, slowly pivot both heels up. Right arm comes back down and left forearm straightens. Back into our forearm plank. A deep breath in and out. All right, now draw both heels over to the right. Start to lift the left elbow up. Pivot on the right elbow so the right hand just comes a little bit more in like a 10 o'clock on a clock face. If you want to, you can bring that bottom knee down to support under your hips or keep both knees lifted. See if you can stack your hips, stack your shoulders to the side in a forearm side plank. Do your best to keep a lift underneath that right hip, active right palm and forearm pressing down into the mat. Breathe in and then out, slowly come back to center. All right, and then lower your hips down. Inhale, pull through the sphinx. Exhale, hold this pose. Keep pressing your feet down. Inhale. Now exhale, lower your torso down, slide your elbows a little bit out to the side, and then sweep your arms forward and back so that your thumbs are pointing down and your pinky fingers up. Pull your shoulder heads up and back. So up first, away from the mat, and back, sliding your shoulders down your back. So your fingers get a little bit closer towards your feet. Keep activating your legs, lift one and then the other off of the mat for Salambasana locust pose. Your gaze is still down at the mat so that your whole spine is long. And this is our first real full body integration. Well, side plank too, but very much so using the support of the ground. We're still very close to the earth. Take one more breath in and then exhale. Stack your palms on top of each other and drop all the way back down to where we started. Forehead resting on the back of your palms, let your heels drop out. And see if you can, again, melt in five breaths. Let it all go. Let your body get long, wide, so that it starts to become vague where the edge of your body is and the air around you begins. Take another deep breath in and out. And slowly lift your head up. Stack your legs strong and long behind you. Press into your palms to bring your forearms back under your shoulders. Press your palms down. Ready for round two? A little bit stronger this time. Sphinx pose to start. Grip your finger pads down. Pull your chest through. Inhale. Exhale. Gaze down. Inhale. Press through your palms. So you find that rounding in your upper back, tuck your toes, lift up forearm plank. Take a breath in, find your strength here, and slide the left palm in a little bit, stack heels. Bring your right hand to your right hip. Now a couple ways you can add on here if you're feeling just super strong tonight. You can stack your legs, lifting your hips a little bit higher. Maybe reach your right arm up. Overhead, palm facing forward. Breathe in and out. And inhale. Right arm comes down. Rock to both toes. Find your forearm plank. Take a breath here. Stack your spine. And then pivot right forearm in, palm down. Over to the right side, either stack or stagger your feet. Use your left hand to make sure that left hip is stacked. And then if you want to reach that left arm up, press more through your right bottom forearm to lift your hips a little bit higher. Do your best to open your chest here, just like we were doing laying on the floor. Deep breath in, and then slowly come down, roll back into forearm plank. Take a breath, exhale, lower your hips down, come to that sphinx pose, press the tops of your feet down, reach your chest through, breathe in, exhale, lower down partway, sweep your arms forward and around, Salambasana. This time, if you want to get a little bit deeper of a chest opener, interlace your hands, pull your knuckles back towards your feet, and then elevate your feet. Keep stretching those toes long and the crown of your head forward. So it's more about length here than a bowing of the body. See if you can press your hips and your core down into the mat. Breathe in, feel your chest open, maybe your arms slightly lift. And then exhale, a little bit of a softening in your belly. Again, inhale. And exhale. Last time, inhale. Exhale, release your palms, bring them back forward, stack, and bring your forehead down. Take just two breaths here to melt down on the mat, belly soft, arms released, legs relaxed, hips heavy. And slowly lift your head up, press your palms down. Bring your forearms back down into Sphinx pose. You want to make sure your elbows are directly underneath your shoulders. Tuck your toes, gaze down, pull your navel up, coming into forearm plank. All right, now if you were practicing with your knees down, for now, I'd like you to work on lifting your knees up, and we're going to slowly walk ourselves into a pike position so that we come into dolphin. So you're going to drop your gaze down between your forearms, tuck your toes, start walking your toes in. Now we haven't opened up the hamstrings yet, so they might be tight. So as you walk in, maybe you walk your feet out. Today, let's all just do it out to start. So feet as wide as the mat, gaze back towards your toes, press your forearms into the mat. Remember that spot between thumb and pointer finger. Press that down and then reach your chest back. Take an inhale into your upper back. Feel it expand, shoulder blades away from your spine. Exhale, chest back. So it's hanging down from your hips. Your forehead, or rather the crown of your head here, is lifted off of the mat. You can keep a gentle bend in your knees. One more, inhale. Exhale, from here, bring your knees down wide, big toes together. Press your arms to straight, child's pose. Forehead down on the mat. If you want a little bit more of a stretch, you can tense your fingers here in this child's pose. So your palms are up. Your whole arm remains elevated and lifted off of the mat. One more deep breath in. And exhale. And bring your hands down and walk them in. Rock forward to all fours, tuck your toes, and lift up to a short down dog. From here, slowly walk your feet forward. Come to find Uttanasana, a nice forward fold at the front of your mat. Let's tuck this guy. All right. Hello. A little bit higher now in our foundation, right? We got some concrete poured, maybe the beginning of some framing on top. Inhale, pull yourself up halfway, Ardha Uttanasana, and then exhale, fold. Plant your hands down and step your left leg back, come into a long lunge. Lower your left knee down to the mat, and then inhale, sweep your arms up, Anjaneyasana, low lunge. Move your gaze forward again. Bottom of the chin parallel with the ground. Keep pressing through your right front big toe and keep drawing your right knee slightly in so it doesn't rock out to the side. Inhale. Exhale, bring your hands down to frame your front foot. And so if you have two blocks tonight, you might want both blocks around that front foot. We're gonna move into Ardha Hanumanasana half splits. So begin to straighten that right leg. As you straighten it, see if you can keep your right ribs attached to your thigh. And then pull your right toes up so your heel is grounded down. Inhale and exhale. Release your chest over your leg. Try and keep those toes pulling back. So you're not pulling more back with your big toe or your pinky toe. Pinky toe is very hard. But instead you have a nice evenness across the top of the foot. Inhale, come back forward. Plant your right foot down. Again, sweep your arms up. Anjaneyasana, low lunge. Reach your fingertips straight up to the sky. Gaze right in front of you, something that's not moving. And now tucking your left toes, your back toes under, you're gonna slowly press up into a high lunge. If you're feeling a little bit wobbly tonight, you can always bring your hands down, lift your back leg, and then sweep up into your high lunge. Do your best to keep your right knee still over that right ankle, back left leg super strong, arms lifted, inhale, exhale, reach forward. Ooh, a little bit of heat in that front hamstring. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, press your right leg straight. Inhale, bend your right knee. Exhale, reach your fingertips forward. So now you have a long line, torso to fingertips, all the way down to your toes. Inhale, arms straight up. Exhale, right leg to straight. Last time, inhale, right knee bend. Exhale, reach forward. Inhale up, exhale to straight. Hold in your pyramid pose. Bring your right hip slightly back. Hinge forward here. Hold for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bend your front knee. Place your hands down and take a big step forward, Uttanasana, forward fold. Hang. Pull your hands up, your shins. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, lift halfway. And then exhale, fold. Step your right leg back. Whew, man. Right knee down. Might try running again, it's been a while. My legs are sore. There might be some groaning. Inhale, sweep your arms up, Anjaneyasana, low lunge. All right, so feel how this can support opening your psoas with the mat. All right, so we're low. Left knee will track forward, press through the big toe mound on that front foot. Gaze is forward. Fingertips straight up. So as you stay heavy and grounded, you can lift and maybe get a little bit of length in your spine. Drawing your ribs in, take a breath. And then exhale, bring your palms down. From here, start to straighten your left leg, doing your best to keep your ribs attached to that thigh, and then pull your left toes back. Flare them if you can. Pull the left femur head back so the hips stay in line in the same plane, vertical plane, as your right knee. And then hinging over that left leg any amount. Again, blocks can work underneath those hands if you'd like. Fold down. Start to gently open up your hamstring. A breath in and a breath out. And inhale and exhale. Inhale, come forward, plant that left foot down, hands down. Inhale, sweep your arms up, Anjane Asana, low lunge. Gaze at a spot that's not moving in front of you. Tuck your right toes. And then in an inhale, so with strength, pulling that integration in, press up, high lunge. Track the left knee forward. Bring the right hip slightly forward so you're not opening out to the side, but instead keeping the pelvis and the shoulders square to the front. Inhale. Exhale, hinge your fingertips forward. So you really feel like that back leg is a launching point, right? A straight diagonal. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, straighten your left leg. Pyramid. Inhale, high lunge. Exhale, tip forward. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, press to straight. You want to keep that back heel really high and lifted. Inhale, bend. Exhale, forward. Inhale up, exhale to straight, hold. Keep actively pressing down through that left foot. And then maybe hinging forward. Breathe in, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bend your front leg, plant your hands down. Exhale, big step forward, Uttanasana. Whew. Drape your torso down. Inhale, pull your hands up your shins, Ardha Uttanasana. And then exhale, fold. Plant your hands down. Bring your knees back down to the mat. So you're in all fours. We're gonna go back into dolphin pose. So back down onto the ground, but we're going to keep feet hip width distance apart as you walk yourself in. Then we're gonna do some heel lifts. All right, so forearms back down on the ground. Grab opposite biceps. So you know that those elbows are directly under your shoulders, and then again, palms down. Now, if your shoulders are starting to fatigue, interlace your hands so that you create like a triangle, and that'll help keep a little bit more integration and less work in the palms. Otherwise, palms press down, forearms pressing into the mat, tuck your toes, press up, hips lift high. Again, think about that spot right between pointer finger and thumb. Press that down like you could glue it down into the mat. Inhale, spread your upper back, lift your hips high, lift your heels. Exhale, walk yourself in. As close as you'll go. Then take a couple breaths here. Feeling this fold, feeling already this is an inversion. Right, so no need to go any farther if this is where you feel like you want to stay tonight. Otherwise, if you'd like a little bit more, lift the left leg high. Now do your best to keep those hips in line. So you don't want to open your left hip up, but instead toes point down towards the mat. Inhale, lift the right heel, and then exhale, drop it. Keep pressing down through your forearms. Inhale, lift your right heel. Left leg is super strong and straight. Exhale down. One more time. Inhale, rock forward. You feel more weight moving into your forearm. Exhale down. Left leg down. Knees down. We're going to take a break between sides. Extend your palms forward. And then exhale with arms straight. Bring your forehead down to the mat. Hips stay over your knees. This is called Anahata Asana. Puppy dog pose, or translation would be heart melting pose. So your elbows are lifted, forehead down, feeling your heart melt down. All right, and then slowly lift yourself up. Bring your forearms back down to the mat. We're gonna now lift the right leg in our dolphin pose. Palms down. Again, you can grab opposite biceps. Then place hands down, spreading your fingers as wide as they will go. Gripping your pads down into the mat. And then gazing back to your toes, tuck your toes under, lift your knees up. Walk your feet in. Press your forearms down, press your palms down, and then feel your chest start to glide a little bit closer towards your shins. Inhale. And exhale. Now keeping that left foot where it is, hip width distance from the right. Start to swing the right leg back. Toes still point down towards the mat. So the right hip isn't stacking, but instead, staying square and then lifting straight up. Now gazing at that left heel, inhale, lift the heel so you come to tippy toes, exhale down. Ooh, inhale up and exhale down. Last time, inhale up, exhale down, right leg down. This time knees wide. Draw your hips back over your heels. Set your forehead down on the mat. Child's pose. Again, you can take that variation where you tense your fingertips, palms up. In and out. And inhale. And exhale, melt your chest down. Slowly bring your palms down if they were lifted. Rock forward to all fours. Tuck your toes, lift up plank, and then hips up and back, downward facing dog. All right, from here, we're gonna lunge forward. Lift your left leg high. And then exhale, thigh to ribs, transition forward into plank, and then set your left foot down. Right, keep the right leg straight, knee lifted, and swing up, high lunge. So straight up into that high lunge. Again, right hip draws forward, left knee tracks over that ankle. Gaze directly in front of you. Keep the back leg super strong. Inhale, start to straighten that front leg, coming into pyramid pose. See if you can maybe lift the left toes up off the mat. Lift your front kneecap up so you're not locking out that leg, but instead letting an integration crawl up that leg from your foundation, from your feet. All right, from here, bend into your front knee, hinge forward, and then step forward, Virabhadrasana 3, Warrior 3. So I'm gonna show you that transition again. From your high lunge, you're gonna reach your fingertips forward, and then press, transition forward. Bring the right hip down. You can flex those right toes so they go straight down towards the mat. Oops, I'm low on that. Love this baby. All right, Virabhadrasana 3. Arms can reach out in front of you, or you can pull your palms into heart center. So by bringing more of the body weight closer to the pivot point, the fulcrum, which is that left leg, making it a little bit easier to balance. One more breath here. And then exhale, slowly bring your hands down, vertical split. Now again, you can place blocks, maybe a water bottle under your hands, or palms or finger pads can come down to the mat. Again, square your right hip down. So the tendency is again to open up here. We want to keep everything nice and square. Right toes facing down, and then drop your forehead towards that knee. Inhale, lift your left heel maybe. Feel the weight move into your hands, and then exhale down. So again, just building blocks. And we don't have to get all the way upside down to start to feel, as you lift that heel, the weight starts to transition forward, that stacking. Last time, maybe lifting that left heel, and then left heel down, right leg back, left leg back, downward facing dog. Take three breaths here. And out. And inhale. And exhale. Last time, breath in. And out. Then lift your right leg high. Bend your knee, thigh to ribs, transition forward, plank, and then right foot down. Stack the knee and the ankle here, and then bring your arms up, high lunge. Actively press through your back leg, heels lifted, to move and shift a little bit of that weight more forward. On your next inhale, press down through that front leg to straighten your right leg for pyramid pose. Again, maybe pull your toes up off the mat so you can feel an integration in this front leg and you're not locking it out, jamming your femur back into your hip. That can also lead to feeling a little bit of that sciatic nerve. So instead, we want to keep a gentle bend, feel the muscles working around. And then bend your front knee. Reach your fingertips forward. Move more weight into that right foot. Gazes forward. Step, launch forward into your Virabhadrasana 3, Warrior 3. Flex your left foot. Think about spinning that left foot down. Arms can be extended, or you can bring your hands to palms, heart center. Keep stomping down through that right leg. One more inhale, and then exhale. Ooh, vertical splits. Again, keep your hips square. So if you see your left toes as you gaze down your left leg, make sure that you rotate that femur head so the toes are pointing straight down to the mat. And then palms down into a block. Lift your right heel up. And exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Ooh, last time, inhale up. And then exhale down. Step your left foot back. Step your right foot back, downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in and out. And inhale. Crawl your hips high, relax your head, neck, chest. Press to your palms, inhale. Exhale, bring your knees down to the mat. All right, so if that felt like a lot of work in those inversions, then you'll practice again doing dolphin pose with just maybe lifting one leg, maybe lifting one leg and finding those heel lifts again. If you'd like to try to maybe kick up a little bit, I like to say that in Pinchi Mayurasana, which is forearm balance, you don't want to kick as much as transfer the weight to stack and then start to lighten the load on that foot so much so that you can bring it up. You can also do this just like we do sometimes handstands against a wall. So with your mat just up against the baseboard of the wall. All right, so pick your journey or where you want to work towards tonight, knowing that you've got a very strong foundation of open hamstrings, open chest and shoulders. And so you just find what your limits are, knowing that you can always build upon them. All right, forearms down to the mat. Press your hands down, lift your knees up. Walk your feet in, find your dolphin pose. Keep the shirt tucked in. All right. And then from there, if you're going to lift one leg up, I'm gonna start with my left, rock, and then drop that right heel. Inhale. Exhale all of the air out. Keep that left leg super straight. And then maybe just lift those toes slightly off the mat. Use your breath. Try and find that lift on your exhale where there's no air in your lungs and you're holding your core in. So just a couple more times, finding that gentle rock enough that you stack, but not momentum. Maybe you find a little hang time. Again, air out. Last time. And then come down. We'll switch sides. Child's pose. If you like Anahata Asana better, you can do that. And then we'll move on to the second side. So forearms down, grab biceps, restack your forearms. And you can do this with fingertips interlaced. It's a little bit harder though, when you actually do get into the inversion because you're balancing the weight into the palm and down the forearm. And so having five individual finger pads to press and find a balance and a distribution of weight is in your favor once you do get into a bigger inversion. So right leg lifts. Inhale, lift your heel. Exhale, drop your heel. Inhale, lift your heel. Exhale, maybe start to lift that left foot up. So one side might be very different
than the other. Remembering to hold
your breath. And then coming down. This time taking embryo pose again. So knees together, forehead down, palms up by your side. Let your shoulders drop forward. Inhale, feel your ribs press into your thighs. And then exhale, feel just this weight kind of drop forward and roll off your back. Again, inhale. And exhale. And bring your hands forward. Slowly come into all fours. And sweep your legs around so that you can come to your back. First time on our back. All the way at the end of the class. Walk your feet in so you can Feel your fingertips graze your heels. Gaze up. You want femur heads running parallel. And then hands can come down by your sides. Slowly press through your feet to lift, starting at your hips and trailing up your spine into bridge. Keep your knees drawn towards each other so they stay stacked over your ankles. And then one thing that I like to do, especially since we have open shoulders, is with your hands, reach with your fingertips, come to the inside of each foot, palm open so the thumb is to the outside. You can walk yourself a little bit closer, just using that pointer finger to hook the inside of your ankle. It'll open your chest pretty nicely. Press through your feet to lift your hips. See if you can relax a little bit in the glutes. Instead, let the feet do the work to lift the weight up onto the top of your shoulders. Take another inhale. Let your hands slip away. Exhale. Slowly lower yourself all the way down. You can let your legs extend forward for Shavasana, or walk your feet out and let your knees drop in. Let your palms open up to the sky. Feel yourself deconstruct slowly back down to the foundation, and then let that structure drop away so that the outline of your body begins to get fuzzy. Where your skin ends and the air begins and blur. Where your back and the floor below you, where your chest and the air above you starts to become one. Slowly start to bring some small movements back into your body. So finding that edge again. No longer relying on vision, but just on the tactile and the feeling of that edge. So maybe even bringing finger pads into the thumb, flexing and extending your feet. And then draw your knees up, placing your feet back down onto the mat. Feel a little pressure at the bottom of your feet. Roll to one side. And gently press yourself up off of the floor. Set your hips down. Stack the framing of your spine. Bring your palms together to heart center. And slowly raise your thumbs to third eye center. Be curious. Follow your bliss. Namaste.